I've done a little bit of gardening. I'm really kind of a city boy. When I grew up, my great-grandparents had a nice big garden there in Memphis. Half the lot was dedicated to it, and that was kind of normal back then. So I've done a little bit of it as I came along, and I was into the whole earth catalog and all that kind of cool stuff. And, you know, the back to the land thing was very appealing to me, and I even tried a little bit of it and found out that, well, dang, that's a lot of hard work. I don't have a garden these days. I don't even have a yard, really. I've got kind of a nature preserve working. If it falls, let it lay there kind of thing. Years ago, I worked with a guy that was a flower farmer, and we grew bedding plants and that kind of stuff, but had gardens there too, you know, tomatoes, grew great tomatoes, and just all kinds of vegetables, you know, asparagus and such. And but we delivered flowers, you know, these little flower shops and stuff. And I met this one girl at one of the flower shops, you know, we kind of hit it off, and we ended up cohabitating at one point in a little concrete block house over in Brookhaven, in what was a pretty dilapidated area. I think it's, you know, kind of high scale now, but, you know, nice wooded area. But we had a garden in the back, and one of the things that I'd read about was using cardboard and newspaper as mulch. Literally, you just take all your debris and put it down there, and like leaf litter and such that you raked up in the yard, or grass clippings, whatever. And then on top of that, you put newspaper, and on top of that, you put cardboard, and then let it sit there all winter. And come spring, you cut little holes out and stick your plant down in there. And that's really literally all you have to do as far as weeding or anything else. You got to water it. It's a real simple and effective technique. And we, even though we were absolutely ignorant about it, we managed to grow some pretty nice tomatoes. And yeah, it can be done. Where I come from, like our tea real sweet, and the front porch is our favorite place to meet. Sunday after church, go to grandma's house to eat. She loves the bustle of the children under her feet. And in my heart, I hold you dearly, and I feel your soul right here next to me. You touch me now, your sweet memory, it lingers with me like jasmine on the breeze. I see your smile, the gleams in your eyes, as you start to rise when I open up your door. And I've seen that look so many times before. Now I don't get to see it anymore. But in my heart, I see you clearly, and I feel your soul right here next to me. And you touch me now, your sweet memory, it lingers with me like jasmine on the breeze. And I love you so, still it's comfort to know you will always